All right, here we are. I'm feeling good again today, and I had me another energetic morning for about the first 4 hours of the day. The reason why I want to make this video is because I had another great revelation, and that is that when you live life, I'm living life right now. I'm just going to say me. I'm not going to point any fingers at you. Put all of it on me, because I carry everything. I am the nuclear-powered carrier of the universe. So, aircraft carrier. Now, see, I'm watching my thoughts, and I'm making sure I'm balancing that with what's going on around me. This is what you do with every brand new thing you say. Now, when you say something, when I say something, I live life today with no definitions. No, all syllables are okay, all words are okay, but I do be safe and I do be peaceful because I got the back door open. And I do loud music in here. You know, all the neighbors are used to me, and I talk to them, and they say, "You're good. You're good to go." And so I can do anything I want around here. And so I went to put some food on the stove, heat some water up for some noodles and macaroni cheese. And yeah, it was just heavy on my mind, that thought of being able to say anything and watch the thoughts go by, and the thoughts will want to get jurisdiction over definition of the words and say this means that and this means that, and then the thought wants to attach certain feelings. Now remember, those thoughts come from the lower brain, the ego, the cerebellum. That's represented by Ishmael in the Old Testament Bible. Abraham and Sarah had two sons. The first one was illegitimate. That's the cerebell. That's the animal brain. But it's still needed. That's the Western world. And then the Eastern world's the cerebrum, which is Isaac. And that's represents the blessed promise. So, if we use our Most High, the Holy of Holies, where the Ark of the Covenant is, where I, the priest, can walk in, and I can give those thoughts, that animal brain that wants to put certain definitions on my words, and I look at the thoughts, and I remind the thoughts, and I interject new thoughts in, and I say, "Oh wait, there's no definitions. There doesn't have to be any definitions attached to these words." And then I bring it to the outer world and get confirmation from Mother Nature. And okay, now I'm going to slow down more. All right, now that I was able to at least get that on the record. That was mostly dominant on the ego side of the brain, the lower brain, because I was in a hurry. Now I'm going to relax. Ah, I just had a pain enter my head right there. Remind the pain. Got a claim a lien. No pain can collect from my well-being of health. And once I say that, I watch the thought go by and automatically synchronize it with awareness of Mother Nature. All these walls are just manufactured Mother Nature, but still Mother Nature. I got the door open. I can feel the cold air coming. It's Indian summer, February. So, good. Yeah. I live life with no definitions on words. When I'm in my own little world over here, create my own reality. And it feels so good. Yes. Feels so good. I got my Miley Cyrus video looking at me. I got it converting to the movie. And there's no definition on that. Just because I used the name Miley Cyrus and I spoke those words, there doesn't even have to be any definition on that. See? And I confirm it by observing the thoughts. And then Mother Nature, around me. That's the inner eye, which is observing the thoughts. And corporate thoughts want to try to gain jurisdiction. And so I interject my own, co-create my reality, and I put my own interpretation of what those thoughts are, and I synchronize it. I glue it in place, I bond it in place by looking around and maintaining that I'm right here so that I don't get locked into the pure spirit of thought of the jurisdiction of the corporate thoughts and just locked in and just down, sink, there I go. Fear, rage, anger, depression, sadness. No. Bring myself out, create the bond, the glue. Always be looking around all the time. Keep your head on a swivel. That's what I learned when I was on the aircraft carrier, the USS Nimitz, from 1986 to 1990. The main thing that I was taught, that was emphasized to me, was keep your head on the swivel when you're on the flight deck. Keep your head on a swivel. And I've learned how to do this by also, you know, the first part of the video, putting living life with no definitions. So now I can watch people's videos, I can listen to anything that they have to say, and there's no definitions put on it. All I'm doing is I'm living in a world of vibration, and I'm just picking up vibrations. And the vibrations that I'm looking to pick up are all the good vibrations. Any bad vibrations that the corporate thoughts, as I'm observing, wants to try to get jurisdiction over me, I immediately co-create my own reality, put my own intention on what those thoughts, make those thoughts my servants. And then a new thought comes by and says, oh, I agree with you now. Yes, you're creating your own world. You're right. And then once again, bond it. Put the glue on it. Look around at the walls. Look at your body. Be here. Because remember, we're both spirit. I am both spirit and body. I am. And we are one. So when I speak about me, I'm speaking about you. When I'm speaking about me and to me, I'm speaking to you. We're one. And now another thing we do is also telepath to all the minds that are in the universe, all the planets, all at the same time. Get that picture in my mind also. So I take it to a universal level of looking at Mother Nature. I use my imagination and faith that I'm speaking to everyone on the earth, and I can see the earth floating in space, and I can see the sun, I can see all the planets and the stars, all the universe, I can see and feel all life forms. There it is. That's the bigger picture. Beautiful. On the record. Awesome. All right. I'm going to check my water.